A lot of you guys already installing macOS on unsupported Macs with OpenCore, and I give you the link to the tutorials if you haven't yet. So I decided to make this video to answer some of the questions, to help you with some of the problems there are maybe an easy fix for, or to point you in the right direction to overcome that problems and to run macOS on your old unsupported Macs. So to make things crystal clear, you install OpenCore on your unsupported Mac and suddenly an update message appears. Whoa, it works. So you click update. Now make sure every time your Mac reboots, the option Macintosh HD is selected. Otherwise, the update won't work and the old version of your macOS just will boot. When you do a install of macOS on an empty hard drive or whatever, make sure that as long as the option macOS installer is available in the OpenCore boot selector, this option is selected. This will disappear after two or three reboots and then the name of your hard disk appears. Just select this and you're done with the installation process. If you would click install macOS Monterey, you would just start the installer that is on your USB drive again, and that doesn't help during the install. So the most common question I read about in the comments is, you have set up everything, your Mac is working perfectly with the new macOS Monterey, but it won't boot without the USB drive. Right, because you boot the OpenCore from the USB drive, which enables macOS Monterey on your unsupported Mac. So the easy solution is, you go back to the legacy patcher, you select download and install OpenCore, but this time you select your system drive as a destination, not the USB drive anymore. Then there should be the EFI partition of your system drive and you install OpenCore to that EFI partition. Now do a reboot without USB drive, keep option key pressed, go to the Apple boot selector, and now you select EFI boot from your system drive, which is OpenCore, which is now installed there. Then you select your macOS, and now your Mac should remember that setting, that it first boots the OpenCore and then your macOS. So when you're in the Apple boot selector or in the boot selector of OpenCore, if you want to set a boot option to standard, just hold shift. And if you hold the shift key, you see that the symbol below the selected option changes to a circle, which means you define this as the standard boot option and your Mac remembers this until you change it again. If you run into problems installing the OpenCore on your system drive, so you're installing it, but when you restart and keep the option key pressed in the Apple boot selector, there's no EFI boot option. It might be either the system integrity protection that is still on, you might switch that off. It might be the formatting of your system drive. So I strongly suggest, if you start with a clean hard disk installing OpenCore and macOS, to format it to macOS Journaled, not to APFS. Some of you, especially with older Macs, like from 2010, 11, 12, do ask, what about the graphics? It's like very slow and it's not displaying correct, and there are some problems with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. So there's a lot of stuff that the post-install patch can fix. You find this in the legacy patcher as a second button from the top. You just click it, you install that to your system drive, reboot, and a lot of that should be fixed. Another tip I got from one of the comments, if you install the post-install patch, you should do that twice. So you install it, then you are, have to enter your password, and when the legacy patcher restarts, install it simply again before you reboot. So if you run into troubles with your display resolution, try the post-install patch in the legacy patcher, and if that doesn't help, it might help when you select a different frequency in the system preferences under the tab display. If you change that, then another menu should pop up that should let you select the correct display resolution. Another very common question was, if I install macOS over my current macOS, will I lose any data? No, you won't. It's as easy as that. If you create a USB drive and you start with OpenCore and you start the installer and then you select install macOS means update macOS. Your files and your data and your config will be kept, but be careful, if anything doesn't work, you might not be able to recover your system. So I strongly advise you to test it first with the USB drive if it boots. Take another hard drive and do a clean install to test everything. And if everything's fine with your Mac, then maybe you just migrate your data to the new drive or you do the update on your current system. There's advice from DOSDude, the guy who created the patched macOS. Don't mix up a patched macOS with the OpenCore and the regular versions of macOS that are just being loaded by the OpenCore bootloader. If you're trying to install OpenCore on a Mac Pro with an updated PC graphics card, you won't see the Apple boot selector because this is only possible with a Mac graphics card. So how to get your Mac Pro now boot, EFI boot, the OpenCore from the USB drive? The easy way is to just use any old Mac graphics card you might have laying around, or you get one off eBay for cheap money and use it just for install. After install, swap back to the modern card. If you don't have a card, just connect an empty hard disk and the USB drive and your Mac should boot from the OpenCore EFI boot because there's no other option. And afterwards you come to the OpenCore boot selector, which works with a PC graphics card. There's an incompatibility between the iMac or the MacBook Pro from 2011 that cannot work with GarageBand or Logic Pro because you get graphic incompatibility error messages. I strongly advise, if your intent to use this music software, that you do not upgrade your 2011 Macs to Monterey.